Hello, this is Dr. Mahesh Kalyanshetti, Associate Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, we'll discuss about the analysis of indeterminate structure by a moment distribution method, wherein we'll focus on beams with sinking of supports. The learning outcome of this session will be, at the end of this session, students will be able to incorporate the sinking effect in the analysis of indeterminate beams using moment distribution method. Let us take one example and then we'll discuss how the sinking effect is to be considered in the analysis. Analyze the beam as shown in figure by moment distribution method, wherein EI is constant and it is also given that support B sinks downs by 10 mm and EI value is to be taken as 75,000 kilonewton meter square. As we know that first of all we need to calculate the stiffnesses of members and joints. Now we have two interior joints here, joint B and C. Let us calculate the stiffness of the joints. For that, we need to calculate the stiffness of the members. So if I consider the joint B here, so we have two members meeting there, BA and BC. So the stiffness of BA will be 4 EI by L since the opposite end is fixed. And stiffness of BC also will be 4 EI by L since it is a continuous support. And the stiffness of the joint B will be summation of the stiffness of the member BA and BC, as shown here. In the same way, if I consider joint C, we have two members meeting at C again, that is CB and CD. So stiffness of CB is 4 EI by L again, because opposite end is continuous, and stiffness of CD also is 4 EI by L since it is fixed. So the total of these two will give you the stiffness of joint C. In this way, we can calculate the stiffness of joint B and joint C. Then we have to calculate the distribution factors of joint B and C. As we already discussed, that the distribution factor is nothing but it is a ratio of the stiffness of the member divided by the stiffness of that joint. So let us consider a joint B here. At joint B, we have two members, BA and BC. So distribution factor BA and distribution factor BC will be equal to the stiffness of that member divided by the total stiffness of the joint. So denominator is nothing but it's a total stiffness of the joint and it works out to be 0.5. Again, if I go to joint C, so here also we have two members, CB and CD. So the distribution factor CB will be a stiffness of the CB divided by the stiffness of the joint C. Here it's a denominator, so it works out to be 0.4. And the distribution factor CD is again the ratio of the stiffness of the CD. This is stiffness of CD divided by stiffness of joint C, which works out to be 0.6. And as already also we discussed that the summation of the distribution factors shall be always equal to 1 at all the joints. So we can see here at joint B, both the members have got the distribution factor 0.5, therefore it is 1. At joint C, the distribution factor CB is 0.4 and CD is 0.6, so therefore summation works out to be 1. Now, after this, we have to incorporate the sinking effect also in the analysis. Now, many time in the structure, the sinking of the support takes place because of the settlement of the supports. And this sinking of the support creates an excessive moment in the members. So these members also we shall consider in the moment distribution process. Now, as it is shown here, if suppose one of the supports sinks down by amount say delta, then there will be a fixed end moment developed having a magnitude of 6 EI delta by L square. So as you can see here, if the right hand support sinks down by delta, the moment produced will be 6 EI delta by L square. and the moment produced will be equal to opposite to the rotation of the beam. Now in this picture it is seen that due to sinking the beam is rotating in clockwise direction. You can see here this point comes down here, so the rotation of the beam is in clockwise direction, therefore the fixed end moments developed will be in anticlockwise direction. So you can see here these are two anticlockwise moments, and the magnitude of these moments will be 6 ci delta upon L square, and the reactions also will be produced accordingly at the supports. So the support reactions produced due to sinking is again 12 ei delta upon L cube. So same reactions we observe here. The same thing if suppose the left hand support sinks down, the same phenomena takes place here. The moment produced will be now in a clockwise direction, 6 ci delta by L square, and the reactions will form a anticlockwise moment. So if the moment is clockwise in nature, the reactions will form anticlockwise moment. Same is the case in the first picture also. So therefore, whenever the sinking of the support takes place, we consider a moment of 6 ER delta upon L square at both the supports, where delta is the amount of sinking at the support. So let us consider this effect in the given problem. Now the fixed end moments, first of all we need to calculate. So span AB, since there is no load here actually, therefore there is no fixed end moment due to loading. However, due to sinking there will be a moment produced, just in the previous slide we discussed. Now this kind of settlement will take place here. So therefore the MAB and MBA both are present. So due to loading, as I told that since there is no loading present, no fixed end moment. However, due to sinking there is a fixed end moment produced, and that is 6 ci delta by L square. And as per our sign convention, the anticlockwise moment we considered as negative. So 6 ci delta by L square, and it works out to be minus 31.25 kilonewton meter. Let us go for the next support, BC. So for support for span BC, there are two effects. One is the fixed end moment due to loading, as well as fixed end moment due to sinking. So due to loading, we know that it's WL square by 12. Therefore, due to loading, the fixed end moment BC is nothing but WL square by 12. So negative sign indicates it's a anticlockwise moment. And CB is positive since it is clockwise in nature. So it works out to be minus 240 kilonewton meter and plus 240 kilonewton meter. And the second effect is the sinking effect. As we know that the left support B is sinking down. Therefore, the moment produced is clockwise in nature, and that is 6 ci delta by L square. Since the moments are clockwise in nature, these are taken as positive, and it works out to be 31.25 kilonewton meter. Therefore, the total fixed end moment for span BC will be summation of these two, that is due to loading as well as due to sinking, and this works out to be total FEM BC is minus 208.75, and total FEM CB will be plus 271.25 kilonewton meter. Then the last span left is CD. Now for CD there is no sinking effect, because sinking is at B only, therefore CD is free from sinking. Therefore the fixed end moment is due to loading only, and we know that this is standard case. The left hand side it is PL by 8, right hand side PL by 8, so it is anticlockwise. Therefore CD is minus 250, and FEM DC is plus 250 kilonewton meter, and due to sinking there is no FEM. So all these fixed end moments we have to consider for the further process. Before that, let us take a pause here and give the answer to this question. First one is, due to sinking the FEM produced at fixed end is, so four options are given. And the second question is, due to sinking the shear force produced at the fixed end is, the four options given. So think over it, take a pause. When you get the answer, resume the video. Welcome back. So these are the answers for this question. Let's come to the most important part of the problem. Now, after getting all the distribution factors, fixed end moments, all these information is to be filled in the standard table. Now we have a joint A, B, C, D. So the member AB, at B we have BA and BC. So it is written here. At C we have CB and CD. And at D we have DC. So these are the distribution factors which were observed. B is 0.5, 0.5 and at C 0.4 and 0.6. Fixed end moments we calculated. All those fixed end moments are to be written here accordingly. And then we have to go for the moment distribution process. We have to balance the joints. Now, for example, if I consider the joint B here, so it is unbalanced because we have minus 31.25 and minus 208. So there is a total minus 240. So minus 240 is unbalanced. So plus 240 we have to apply. Out of plus 240, 50% here, 50% here, it is to be applied. So here also, at C also, if you look at it, is unbalanced. So find the unbalanced moment, and opposite of that unbalanced moment is to be applied. And out of that total, 0.4 fraction will be transferred here, 0.6 fraction will be transferred here. And then the carryover will take place. Since the A is fixed end, so carryover 50% is transferred here. And then from C also towards D, 50% is transferred. And from B, carryover takes place towards C. And from C also, carryover takes place towards B. So in this way, the carryover takes place. And we have to go for number of iterations. You can see here, after the carryover, again the balancing get disturbs. And that is to be again balanced. So in this way, the iterations are to be taken. So after taking four iterations, it is observed that the unbalanced moment left is very, very small. And therefore, we can stop there. And after the process is over, you can take a summation of all these moments. The final moments will be obtained here. So the summation of moment AB, BA, BC, CB, CD, and DC all are given here. Once this moment distribution process is over, then the free body diagrams are to be determined or drawn. So as diagram, next job is to draw the bending moment diagram. So based on the moments produced here at the supports, this is the bending moment diagram we obtain. So these are the references which are used for the presentation. Thank you.